Well, I mean, I'm going to go on that topic of tax.
Yep.
And the first item being, and I think you looked into it a bit more than I did. Everyone knows we kind of went off last time that HRM proposed a, was it 7% increase or 6% increase?
5.9.
5.9%. Yeah, 6%. So 6%, half being a climate action tax and the other being just due to inflationary pressures on property taxes, even though their assessments across the board have gone up more than they ever have, higher than they ever have. And they had a massive de-transfer tax windfall that they've also never had before. And they've had that now for 2 or 3 years.
And wouldn't have budgeted for.
Exactly. And would not have budgeted for. And they openly
found
say
money.
It,
found money.
It's newfound money. And like it blew everything out of the water. And in response, they're going to have a larger than ever property tax increase. But now on the flip side, New Brunswick's also facing a lot of growth similar to Halifax.
Yeah, Moncton specifically. And this is the municipality in question. They've realized that they're going to have just over a 10% increase in property assessment.
Yeah, which would be similar to here.
Yeah, so
if not less,
it's less than here. Yeah. So what they did is they dropped their property tax by 6%
to encourage growth.
Not only to encourage growth, but just to be like, we have more money than we did before.
They have a budget; they're going to meet it.
And given everything that's going on, maybe collecting every single penny that we can is not what we want to be doing. So they dropped their property tax rate by 6%. Now, anyone in council who's listening to this, which no one is, though Mike Savage was in here right before here, because he's got, check out the Mic Drop. He's got a podcast here as well, PNV.
I like the name.
It is a sick name. They're going to say, but our property tax rate is technically lower than Moncton's, because Moncton's now is going to be about 1.56, but those rates move inversely with property values.
Yeah.
Right? So they are lowering their tax rate.
It's also an irrelevant point. One thing went up, the other can come down.
Yeah, yeah.
They don't need to both go up.
Well, both going up is double counting.
Right, but that's the thing. I'd love to see that stat, like the average assessment increase, and then look at that new assessment and then the new tax rate on that. So that actual tax increase to the average person is not 5.9%.
Yeah, it's greater than that. Yeah.
It's much greater.
It's double counted.
So
yeah, and this is like Moncton's doing well, man. I know we hear this all the time. Every now and again, I'll have someone like kind of
debating
peripheral
and be
like, oh yeah, I'm looking in Moncton and I know some guys who like sold everything here and then bought a bunch of stuff in Moncton. I know you do things across the border. Like,
yeah.
You know, so good on Moncton. It's great for the general area, like the Atlantic provinces, to have Moncton be strong. But what a nice little piece of news and a big contrast. Like that is a shot over the bow. Like if these municipalities, they go to these, you know, conferences and they go to these big corporations to pitch, right? Yeah. Why come here? That's a shot over the bow of anyone looking to invest in either Moncton or Halifax. Property tax goes up over here, 6%, goes down.
One of the biggest complaints, too, for investors in Moncton has been the tax rates. So they're trying to show it. They're trying to make the change.
There's something different, though, in New Brunswick. There's an absentee tax. It's like, as soon as you leave the province, your tax rate goes up. It's like triple. Like, it's something wild.
Oh, cool.
So say you have a house there, and then you move to Halifax, and you rent your house out, your tax rate goes up, like, exponentially.
No way.
Okay, now that you said that, now we're going to get a new HRM proposed tax.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, like we can do what?
Absentee tax. So.
Yeah.
While you were on vacation, we prorated it for 7 days.
That's right.
That your tax rate is actually 3.5%.
Yeah.
When I was broke, I had rich habits. When I was broke, I had rich habits.